Yeah, if you can just come to the scream and say, got it, oh baby, I've got it. Okay, beautiful. So bring one hand to your heart. Feel that physicality, the warmth or the cool. Just supporting you to settle inside the animal feeling sensing body. And bring your other hand just below your navel to your belly. So we spoke a little bit about the lunar eclipse. This astrology can make people feel that their nervous system is a bit overloaded and a bit overwhelmed for some. So by relaxing into your body, aware of your breath, and just keeping your mind focused on coming back to the sensation of the breathing, feeling the air. And when we're in strong times, it's really helpful to remember we're in them together. So as you feel down to the base of your body, your sitting bones, your pelvic floor, just relax the muscles of the pelvic floor and send awareness into the ground, the same earth that we're all sat on all over the globe, or stood on, or lying on. And just tune into that connection that we all have through the earth. And just like the beautiful mother that she is, let her energy hold your body, nourish you. And then we take our awareness skywards, just tuning into the vast, infinite space around us and above us and inside us. Just tuning into infinite space. And then bring your hands into a, just like you're holding a ball of energy. And we're just going to do the ocean wave movement. So as you breathe in, the arms open a little, and as you breathe out, they come together. And with each in-breath, the hands go a little bit wider. Just feel that you're opening your energy field into spaciousness. It's really expanding into your fullest stretch of your arms. And feel your heart power expanding. And then gradually let those ripples of breath come inwards. And a gentle reminder again to sense, feel into the sensation in your hands. And one of your hands is going to reach up towards sky, palm to sky, and the other hand palm to earth in the heaven and earth stretch. And then they pass, just feel them passing at the heart center. And then in the other direction, heaven and earth stretch. So I'll stand up so you can see this a little bit more clearly. You can do it standing or sitting. Just in your own way, tune into the energy between sky and earth through your body, the vertical alignment. Amrita Nandatmikamishri. So our music's going to change now into something more lively. So we can start our shaking. So if you'd like to just release any tension in your fingers, in your wrists, and in your elbows. And I'll just turn the music up a bit. I think it's a little bit quiet, isn't it? Just turn it up for you guys. So we've got a little bit of Santana. I think this is this Santana? Yeah. Have it quite loud. Please have a good old shake to Santana. Remember the feet. If you have been feeling a bit stressed or overwhelmed, this is your opportunity to shake it off, to release the tightnesses, the tensions. Just enjoying the music. If you feel like moving around your space, trust your body and how it wants to move. Remember to release the head, the neck, gently. Remember those bums. Shaking, just slow down. And then that same connection with each other. So imagine we're in a circle holding hands and we're just stomping in a tribal rhythm together. Still holding hands in a circle, come into the circle, closer to each other. And you'll know this, when you've done Biodanza, you go right into the middle of the circle, and then you just sort of imagine that you're on each other's bodies, having a little bounce, like Ribena bubbles. Brilliant. And we move away from each other, holding hands in the circle, feeling that tribal strength of our circle, in it together. Okay, let's come into the middle and just bounce together. So you might have a shoulder on somebody else's shoulder, you might have your back on somebody else's back. Feeling that connection, that physical connection. Okay, and then stepping back again. And we're just going to move into a twist now. As you do this, I'm going to turn the music down so you can feel your energy a little bit more and change the music. Okay, so as the music changes, become a little bit more sensitive, a little bit more subtle in your sensing of the energy in your body. There's an invitation to breathe a little deeper gorgeous. Moving into a slightly different twist now. So there's a feeling of openness, you know, like a full moon, like a sun, just really shining, radiating your energy out. And then you move into a twist like this. You radiate out and twist. That's it. You've got it, everyone. Imagine that you're like a sunshine and you're radiating out. As we go into the winter, obviously we can get a little bit like we want to go in our caves and hide away, and that's okay too. But for now, we're focusing on that radiating, shining out the energy. Okay, lovely. And we're just going to take those legs a little wider if that's okay for you. And as though you're pushing through water. Now honour your body. If your body's feeling tired, just, or you've got your, you know, problems with your feet or your backs or your shoulders, just honour what you need always. And then we're going to push across. To protect your knees, take your knees with you. Take your knees with you wherever you go. Okay, so together, feel the feet on the earth. And as you do a beautiful infinity symbol, figure of eight, come down to the earth together. Just feeling the sensation of the texture of whatever's under your feet. Feeling the air on your skin. And gradually bring these arms at heart level. Just finding a beautiful flow. Releasing the energy in your spine, your neck, clearing your heart, creating space around you and inside you. And then we come up to that lunar eclipse that's building. And as we tune into that, we tune into whatever is wanting to be expanded in our life, what wants to grow, and what wants to be released. So now let your figure of eight go wherever it wants to. Just be creative in the flow. You might even want to move it around the room. Just finding a speed that works for you today. Oh, I can feel the Uranian lightning bolts. Beautiful. Just coming to a stillness, one hand on hip, one hand at the side of you. And as this hand sweeps down, the knee comes up behind you. I'll show you this way around. So it's, and you can see that my body is bending one way and the other. A bit like a pendulum, that's it. Any energy that's stuck, we're just freeing up the body, and then the other way. Okay, coming to stillness. I just want to check, can you hear me okay, or do I need to put the music down? Thumbs up, yeah. Everyone okay, fab, thank you. Okay. So for a moment, withdraw your eyes from the screen. Open to the sound of the music. And really come home to yourself. Sensing your aliveness. Backs of hands together. And as you breathe in, energy rising up to the sky, to that moon. And as you exhale, flow down into forward bend, palms to earth. And then your palms come up, backs of legs. As you slowly stand up, you take a little back bend with strong core, strong tummy muscles. And then you flow forward. So the hands are just on the, they don't touch the legs. They're just in the energy field behind the back of legs. Palms to earth. Backs of hands together. So feel that beautiful, nourishing earth energy rising up like sap, opening to the energy of the moon and bringing that light down through you and around you. The hands trace up the aura of the back of the legs. As you move into your gentle back bend. One more time. I'm just going to come and watch you. Now this time, keeping the body upright, just take a lovely deep breath in. As you breathe out, the hands float down. And we repeat that in breath and out breath. And as we do that lovely deep in breath, just tuning into the energy of a full moon. I don't know about you, but I find the full moon absolutely magnetic. One more time. Beautiful. And then if you can bring yourself to sitting, you might want a meditation cushion or, you know, just a cushion. We're going to come down to the ground. Let's get the other computer. My head off. Okay, let me just bring you close to me. So if this is not comfortable having cross-legged, cross-leg legs, just put your legs wherever you want them to be. So the moon is associated with the Svadhisthana center, the sacral center. So imagining your belly, I don't have to imagine this actually, that your belly's a big ball. So we've got this big ball of energy in the belly and we're going to circle and to support us to calm. You imagine that in the bowl of your pelvis, there's like a beautiful lake. And as you do this gentle movement, the waters of the lake become more and more still. taking the movement out into big, big circles. And then changing direction. And all of your instinct, all of your awareness in your Svadhisthana, your sacral center, your creative center, and let the spiraling get smaller, gradually smaller and smaller, until your body, in its own time, like a spinning top, settles into stillness. And bring the awareness up from the sacral center, up through the spine to the center of your brow, your forehead. And just sense a beautiful full moon. It's a blood moon today, apparently. There's a beautiful glowing reddish moon in the center of your forehead. And then you just bring your hands consciously to touch earth. It might be your fingertips, depending on how long your arms are, hands to earth. And we take a lovely deep breath in, stretching tall. And as you breathe out, opening the sides of your body. Just holding it there for a moment or two. And then breathe in and out. Other side, deep breath in. As you breathe out, opening those intercostal muscles. Breathe in and out. Now, slightly more difficult, excuse me. You hold this wrist with this hand, stretch up, and then you're pulling. This hand is pulling that hand over to give you an even stronger stretch. Breathe in, push hands to sky. Change your wrists. So you're pulling this hand down with this hand, or try and keep that elbow back if you can. Beautiful. Breathing in, pushing to sky. And then just let the hands float down. And if you're not already there, some of you did this earlier, you can take your legs to a comfortable side stretch for you. Excuse me. Fingers to the earth. And we just bring our hands forward. Now, if possible, keep your chest open and the front of the body nice and wide, so you're not sort of going like that. You've got a lovely, that's gorgeous, well done. And then when you've held that for a couple of seconds, take a deep breath in. And as you breathe out, you can now let the spine fold forward, the back of the neck relax. Sighing, releasing, letting go. Find a way you can be here that is a relaxed, soft, melting. Thank you.
On your next exhale, uncurl the spine.
And bring the soles of your feet together. And then with your thumb, you're going to massage that place, sort of just in the middle, above the ball of your foot. And do that however's comfortable for you. You might want to do it cross-legged, or you might want to do it like this. So we're digging our thumbs. Ow, that's a little bit sore. How is that for you? So at these strong emotional times, grounding into the body is a beautiful thing to do for your nervous system. So when you feel complete with that, you can just massage the whole of your foot, hoping none of you have got a dislike of feet. I know some people don't like massaging their feet. If you're one of those, do your hands. And in the yoga tradition, we've got chakras in the soles of the feet, and also in the Chinese medicine. And they support us to be really open to the earth energy. They're beautiful. Now, if this is comfortable for you, place your elbows on your knees like this, and with that nice open front of the body, see if you can fold yourself forward a little. You might not go very far. That's brilliant. So we're consciously relaxing the pelvic floor, belly, the hip flexors, and then when you're ready, take a deep breath in. And let yourself flow forward with a rounded back. That's it. So is it possible to soften even more, to relax even more? Neck, shoulders, face. The energy yin, receptive, relaxed. That's beautiful. And with your next out breath, slowly uncurl. I'm sort of arguing with myself in my own head now about whether to do this next one, because it's kneeling, and I don't know. I know not everybody is happy with the knees. So if you don't want to kneel, you can do it like the side bend, like this, in this position. For those of you who want to kneel, I might have to bring the camera up a bit now, I think. Let's do that. So yeah, your choice. Oh, I've chopped my head off now. This is annoying. It's okay. So let's have a look at you. Are you going to do it standing up, Rosie? So you can either be kneeling. Oh, are you kneeling? It's just I can't see your knees. Okay. So your leg goes out to the side. Now, have a look at this supporting leg. Sometimes people are a bit too much that way or a bit too much that way. Make sure this is perpendicular to the floor. On your inhale, you raise the same hand as the leg that's up. And then you go over to the side, fingertips to the earth. And again, we're opening up the intercostal muscles. Hi, Nala. And then breathe in as you come up. And as you breathe out, go the other way. That's looking good, guys. You've got your elbows nicely back. Inhale up. Exhale over. Just stretching as far as you can. And then, optional extra, pull in your tummy, stretch your arm as though you're pointing to that straight up above you. Slightly move your weight over and lift that leg up. It always gives me cramp in my bum, this. Oh. And recover in your own way. The Angie's wiggling her bottom. Little doggy, stretch. Okay, other side now. The layers are coming off. Getting warm. Okay, so we start with raising this arm, same arm as the leg that's out, breathe in. And then reaching down with your fingertips to the floor as you go into your side bend. You're keeping your elbows beautifully back to get that strong stretch. That's fantastic. Breathe in. And then side bend the other way. So hoping you can feel it right the way down your side, maybe even to the top of your hip. Strong stretch. Breathe in. So this time, this hand just goes straight up to sky. And if you want to, engage your core and lift the leg. Oh, shit, I've just kicked the something or other drum, I think it was. And let's all do Angie's bum wiggle. Wiggly, wiggly, wiggly. That's good. Brilliant. Fab. If you want a cushion under your bottom for the next one, it could support your back. So we're going to have our legs forward. It can be a little bit supportive of your lower back to be slightly perched upon the cushion. We do this slightly differently today. Instead of coming back into the heart as we normally do, we're going to do a circular, like a full moon shape with our arms. Stretch up really tall. And then as you breathe out, extending forward with a long back, open chest. It's looking great. Deep breath in. And as you breathe out, just soften your neck, your shoulders, your face, your lower back, your arms. Just coming into a beautiful, receptive, relaxed forward bend. So that it's pleasurable for the body, only take it to where it feels bearable. You know, you don't want to be in pain. Just relax. Keep softening, surrendering. And sometimes when the energies are strong, the wise thing to do is to surrender, to let go, to go with the flow, to bow to life. Slowly uncurl. If it feels good to you, you might want to massage backs of legs. That was quite a strong, obviously, strong hamstring stretch. Can you slightly move? I don't know if you can, Angie Miller-Smith. Because I can only see the top of your head. That's better. If you want to be seen, of course, you don't have to be seen. But yeah. And a bit the same with you, Flora. Only if it works for you. Yeah, that's better. That's better. Thank you. Okay. So we'll do dog stretch now. So if you come onto all fours and have gorgeous spread fingers and spread toes to the best of your capacity, spread your fingers, spread your toes, and lift your bums way up in the air. And do the walk the dog. So one heel and then the other. Now, if ever you're experiencing fatigue or exhaustion or tiredness, the dog is a brilliant one to do as a little pick me up. So some of you will want to stay here. Some of you will want to rest in child. Find a way that you can be here in a peaceful, relaxed way. Finding stillness at the center of the posture. And your body will tell you when it wants to come down. And you can come down to extended child when you're ready. So wide knees, room for your belly, hands stretching in front of you. Softening the heart to earth. Great, well done. And find a way this can be comfortable for you. You might want to even have a couple of fists for your head to rest on. So relaxing in child. See what your body wants. Some of you might want to do that again, the dog once again. If you want to stay in child, do that. So fingers spreading, toes spreading, lifting bums. So it's the pooling of blood in the head, the upside down posture that's helping energize. Now you can play around with slightly bending your knees and lifting your tail up in the air. Just see how that feels. And then press the heels down with the back becoming straight. And you rest whenever you need to in child.
Brilliant, well done.
You can choose now to sit either on the floor, on a chair. You can kneel or be cross-legged. I'm going to be in the Vajrasana kneeling, but you don't have to be here. You can be cross-legged or even on a chair. And I'll come closer to the screen so you can see this. So we are giving the wrists a bit of TLC after the strong dog. So just enjoy massaging your wrists on each other. We're really tuning into that Taurian sensuality and love of touch and pleasure in the body. And a little circling, shaky circle. Shaky circle the other way. Okay. So I think with it being a lunar eclipse, it would be really good to do the moon sequence today. But I'm going to show you. I'm going to turn the music down a bit. So when you kneel, I'll get my head back in a minute. When you kneel, you can either be like this or like this, so that the hip flexor's getting more of a stretch. So it's entirely up to you. You can be or somewhere in between those two. So let's prepare our bodies for the long kneel. Do you hear? You bring your fingertips to the floor and just come forward as far as you can. Or if you can't reach the floor, you can have your hands on your knee like this. Heart forward. And then as you take your weight back, you just fold your body down over this front leg in a way that's comfortable to you. Just take a nice deep breath in and out. Transfer the weight onto the front foot. So you're pushing forward, lifting the heart. You could even come to here if you wish. And then straightening, stretching that back leg, the front leg, sorry. And just one more time. This time, interlock your hands behind you and just lift the hands up, so you're really lifting the chest. That's beautiful. And then find a way of moving to the other side. So can you feel it here on the hip flexor when you push forward? This is the psoas muscle. It's known as the muscle of the soul. So we're going to stretch forward, fingers to the earth if you can reach or hold your knees. That's great. Your heart is lifted. And then as you transfer the weight onto the back knee, you fold over your front leg. That's beautiful. Do that one more time. Come forward, stretching your psoas muscle.
And back.
Oh, we've got groovy music's come on. Okay, then coming forwards. Interlock your fingers behind you if that's okay for you. Lift your heart forward. Twist and shout. I don't know about you, I'm getting really hot. Right, let's find some moony loony music. Tweet soul fine. That sounds quite nice, light of my soul. Right, I reckon before we do this, let's connect in, because it's probably time. Full on, yeah, we're nearly there with the eclipse. So hands to prayer position. You can either kneel or sit cross-legged, however works for you. If kneeling down is uncomfortable, you can kneel up. Just whatever's, yeah. Okay, so here we all are. In this moment. With our past behind us and our future in front of us, full of possibilities. So as we practice this moon sequence, a really lovely intention would be to align ourselves with what life is wanting to bring to us. Align ourselves with the Wu way, the way of things. So as we let go of trying, let go of effort, let go of pushing, just relaxing with life. So dependent on your knees and how you're feeling, you could do this in warrior leg if you prefer. You don't have to do it in the kneeling. I'll move further back. So we come up to high kneeling or standing. And we're opening a pathway from our heart forward. And we bring one of our legs forward, the left leg ideally for the moon side. And you open your arms, expanding the heart energy. Breathe in. Reaching up to that beautiful eclipse energy and slicing down through illusion. Opening yourself to your future. And bring the fingers of the leg that's forward to the earth and just look down to the earth. Thank you, Mother Earth. And then look up to that moon. We come to the center. And the other hand comes down to earth. And as we look down to earth, just thanking her for her nourishment and looking up to the moon. Come into the center. And your palms turn up as though you're holding the bottom of a glorious full moon. Breathing to the highest in you. And we bring that highest potential here into your heart, planting that seed in your heart. And just lowering down, or stay high kneeling if that's what's best for you. And just take a moment again, sitting however's comfortable for you. Tuning in to life. What's life showing you at the moment? What's life bringing you . So when you're ready, we come up to high kneeling and bring the right leg forward this time. If you want to come further forward, you can. Just do what's right for you. Breathe in, and as we breathe out, the fingers push forward, making a line of light from your heart into your future. Opening the arms wide, breathe in. Arms to sky, holding that moon energy, reaching up. And slicing through illusion. Breathing in. Fingertips down to the foot. Thank you, Mother Earth. And then looking up to Sister Moon. Back to center. And the other way. So just feeling into our earth, thanking her, and then up to the moon. Back to center. Palms to sky. So you're opening yourself to your highest potential. Planting that seed in your heart for the future you. Bring your hands to your heart. Sit however's comfortable. You might even want to lie at this point. So feeling into your heart. Just honoring yourself for your journey so far. Opening yourself to the adventures yet to come. You all are. Some of you are lying, some of you are sitting. Okay, just see what the time is. Oh yeah, okay. So if you're cold, grab a blanket or put a jumper on, slippers. Wrap yourself up lovely and warm. Allow this beautiful African soothing rhythm soothe your soul, soothe your heart. So we'll take a journey. Just make sure your body is as comfortable as it can be.
Keruru dokitala
feel into your eyes. Softening the eyelids. And we're going to take ourselves to a beautiful, warm and balmy night with a full moon. And you're lying on a beach. Try and use your senses, your inner vision, your inner hearing, to really find yourself in that warm country under that bright, beautiful moonlight. The gentle sound of the sea lapping on the shore. Just allow the soothing sound of the waves and the African rhythms settle you and calm you. Awareness coming to your heart area now. Just feeling into the heart. Allowing that soothing moonlight to bring serenity to your heart. That beautiful silvery light filling your chest. It's almost as though you have a beautiful full moon glowing from the center of your chest. Awareness moving down to the Svadhisthana chakra, the sacral. Breathing easily and gently, barely just gently rising and falling. And like we did earlier, imagining a beautiful, still lake in your pelvic bowl. It has become so still now that it reflects the perfect reflection of the moon in the sea. Your back, Flora. You had a little internet bleep. So we're just feeling into the sacral center. We're imagining a beautiful still lake in the bowl of the pelvis with the reflection, perfectly mirror clear reflection of the full moon in the lake. legs. And just one more track to just enjoy the sound, enjoy the stillness. I'm going to turn it up a little bit.
Feel the rhythm of your heartbeat. Feel the rhythm of your heartbeat.
Starts building a bit more energy, start to return a little bit of movement to your fingers, to your toes, just welcoming yourself gradually back little stretches. Just do whatever you need. I know, I'm aware, Rosie, you need to go, don't you? Yeah, lovely, lovely to see you. For the rest of you, just taking your time to emerge back, come back. I'm going to finish with a lovely mudra sequence. So just need to be sitting comfortably. Yourself to sitting however's comfy for you. So while you were lying and relaxing, I found my body doing these movements, so I thought we'd do them together. So you have one hand over your sacral center, fingertips pointing down to earth. And you have one hand over your third eye center, fingertips pointing to sky. Both of these chakras, the third eye and the sacral, associated with moon energy. And then you sort of push the hands in opposite directions, one earth, one sky, go round in a big full moon shape until the hands change. Breathing in as you circle round. Exhale as the hands come to the chakras in balance. But with the Yana Mudra, this mudra. Open the fingers as you go round. Gesture of wisdom, the Yana Mudra. Bring your two mudras, your gestures of wisdom, in front of the heart so that the circles come together. And we're just going to take that mudra up to the moon. And then it changes into the lotus mudra. So you're offering your spirit, you're opening your spirit to receive the gifts of this lunar eclipse, bringing it down. And then anchoring it as a bud in the heart. I'm going to stop the recording now so you can come and we can have a little chat if you like.